Welcome to today's webinar. Topic today is model and design reinforced concrete structures in RFM 6 and RStab 9. My name is Andreas Hörold. I'm responsible for marketing and public relations in the Bluebile software company, and I will be the moderator today.
Hello together, my name is Alexander Mayhofer. Together with Mr. Dlubal, I'm responsible for the development of a reinforced concrete design in RFM and in RStab.
Yes, hello also from my side. My name is Paul Kieloch. I'm working on the support hotline. And in the last months and years, I was also busy with end testing of the new RFM 6, including its concrete design add-on. And today I have the pleasure and honor to show you a brief demo about our new program.
Yeah, my name is Adrian. I'm also responsible for customer support, especially related to concrete design. I'm also part of the development and in RFM 6, especially for construction status analysis.
Okay, thank you for introduction. We can close our webcams that the attendees can see the full screen. If you have any question, you can enter this in the control panel that you can see on the right side of your screen. You can open it with that arrow here. If you don't get an answer during the webinar because there are too many, you will get an email afterwards. The other way is to watch the entire webinar and then email your questions to info@bluebile.com. To the agenda today, at first, Paul will model a reinforced structure or concrete structure, a simple structure, not the structure on the right side of the screen. He enter loads and use the combinatorics in RFM 6. Then it follows the design of the simple structure and also of the building structure here, and then the documentation in the printout report. I hand over the screen to Paul. Just a moment. So, Paul, it's your turn.
Okay, you do see my screen?
Yes, that's okay.
Perfect, then I can start. So, thanks for the introduction, Andreas. As already said, I will create at first a small beam with a cantilever just to give you an overview about the new concept in RFM 6, how we plan to create models including reinforcement design, and therefore I'm opening a new file, and I would name it just like beam with a cantilever. Okay, and I will use the 3D model without any template, and that's basically it on this tab here of this dialog. And if we are creating models in which we want to consider also the concrete design, then we should directly switch over to the next tab here in this dialog, to the add-ons. And maybe someone of you already has also joined previous webinars to the new RFM 6. There you can find all the add-ons for the new program. So here on the left side you see add-ons regarding the analysis, like for the nonlinear material model and so on, and dynamics. And here on the right side, there we have our design add-ons, and there you find the concrete design add-on. So I will activate it here. So we have here the concrete design now activated, and by default also the combination wizard and the load wizard. So these options are checked on, and when these options or add-ons are activated, we can also switch to the next tab here regarding the standards, and there you find all available standards, and we can just check what's available here. So regarding the classification, you find these standards here, so you can choose whatever you prefer for your structure. Today I will stay here for the Eurocode, so I'm leaving this with the default settings here, but just to give you an overview also what's available currently for the load wizard, there we have just Eurocode and standard for Switzerland. And for the concrete design add-on, we have currently four standards implemented, so the Eurocode, the ACI for America, CSA for Canada, and for the Russian standard, we have also a solution implemented currently. For sure, there will be also further standards in the future, but that's the current state of the program. If we have chosen here the Eurocode 2, then you have the option to select also a certain national annex. For our today's presentation, I will leave it with the general recommendation for the Eurocode. Now, that's basically it. So you see also here in this table the configuration of the standards for your structure. I can confirm it with OK. And then I get a default empty file here. By default, if you open a new file, then RFM is loading the last used material section and thicknesses. I will delete this here just to create it with you from scratch. So we will start with a new material, so therefore I'm clicking here on new material, opening the material library, and there you see a filter option here on the left side. There you can filter for a certain region and for a certain material type. So at first I will filter here for the concrete, and I would like to use this one here, confirm with OK, and then we have the first material, and the second one will be now here the reinforcing steel, and that is already a difference to our previous program generation RFM 5. There the reinforcing steel was not a part of the RFM model itself, it was a part of the add-on. So the whole add-ons are now, or the reinforcement is now a part of the structure itself, so we have to define already a reinforcing material here directly in our RFM model. So I will create, let's say, this one here, and we have now two materials. Just for info, if you have here, if you click on the concrete here, then you can activate also creeping and shrinkage here in this material parameters. Then we confirm that, and we have created our materials here in the data navigator, you see it here. The next topic would be a section. So I'm creating a new cross section, and the dimension of this cross section should be 300 by 50 millimeters. So a standard rectangle cross section, and with this data we can create our first member. So if I'm using this option here, and if you have activated the concrete design add-on in the basic data dialog, then the program has activated by default also the design properties here for this member. So that means if these design properties are activated, you will get all these tabs here regarding concrete design properties. I will open it later, second time, just to show you this function here regarding this design properties. So I will create here the first beam. It should look like this. So it has a, it's basically just a straight beam with a length of 8 meter here for this example, just to give you an overview how this in general works. The next topic I would like to care about is the supporting or the support. So I'm using here nodal support. It should look like this for this part of the structure. And now I said that I would like to have here a beam with a cantilever. So in this part of the structure, I'm missing a node is missing. So therefore, I would like to divide this member into two parts. So therefore, I'm using this option, member divide member, and then with a certain distance. And I'm entering it here with 75% from the start of this member. And one option I will activate here with this check is that I will not create or divide this member actually in two separate members. I will just create a new node with the type on member. So we will still have a one continuous beam here. And now it's maybe not so visible, but therefore I will switch to the wireframe display mode. And there you see this blue node here, and this node has the type on member. So actually we can now assign here a support, and the beam is supported, but the member was not divided through this node here. So it looks like this. If you would like to increase the size of these supports, then you could can also use a new function here in Orpham 6. You can just do a right click on the supports, and there we have this new slider here, and with this new slider you can directly adjust your size of the supports. So you directly see these changes on the structure. So that's also pretty handy in the new program generation. Next step would be assigning the loads. Therefore, I need some load cases. By default, I have here the first load case with the self weight. I will create just two further load cases for the live load. So I can select here the action category for the live load here, and I will just copy it. So we have one load case for the self weight and two load cases for the live load. And if I switch back here to the tab with base data, then you see that the combination wizard is already activated. And here you see the previously selected national annex for the combination wizard. So you could also modify it here if you want to. With the settings, I'm switching to the actions. There we have basically just two action here for the dead load and for the live load. The next tab would be regarding the design situations, and that is basically the same like before in Orpham 5. So by default we have here these four design situations, but the new thing is that here in this tab you can already decide whether this loads which are coming from this design situation should be considered for the concrete design. So in this case, or in this tab, you could also create further design situations and deactivate them, for example, for the concrete design, and consider them, for example, if you have a bigger structure for the steel design. So you could create one design situation where you have first order analysis, and then a second design situation, also an ultimate limit state with second order analysis, and consider one for concrete design and the other one for steel design, for example. In our case, we will consider all four design situations here for the concrete design, so I'll leave it activated like it is. Switch to the next tab here with the action combinations, and for all these action combinations we get also here this load combination. So that is basically, or that are our combinations for the example here. I confirm that with OK. And then I can switch here to the load cases and add here the loading on the structure. Therefore, I will use regular member loads. In the first load case, 10 kilonewton per meter. And there is a new feature here, because in the previous program generation, it was not possible to switch here in this tab between the individual load cases, but here you can now select in which load case you want to apply this load. So I would like to apply this 10 kilonewton per meter on this beam here in this load case 1, apply next, then you see it in the background, and you can leave this dialog here open, switch to the next load case, select also this member. And now I can change the load distribution type and say, for example, that I want to enter 20 and 20 kilonewton per meters from 0% to 75%. Apply next. And then I'm switching to the load case number 3 here, and I'm just switching from 75 to 100% and entering here the 1 for the member number 1, clicking on OK. And then we have here this load applied, and as already said before, it is still one continuous member or beam, so we have just one element basically, and that is a new feature here with this node or member, where we can keep the amount of elements a little bit lower, and I think it's also better for the overview of the whole structure if you do it like this. After entering these three load cases, we can just switch, for example, here to this line for the design situation 1. That is basically something like the envelope result combination in RFM5. So if you click here on this design situation 1 and then on this I to calculate the results, then RFM is calculating the results inside this envelope. And you get, for example, here the deflections, or we could also switch here inside the statical analysis results to the internal forces on the members, for example, on the shear force, and then you can just increase it a little bit. Then you see here this envelope of the internal forces here in this beam. And for this internal forces, with the already predefined default reinforcement configuration, I can just start the calculation in the add-on. So I can switch here in the concrete design add-on in the tab Objects to Design. By default, the program tries to analyze all elements in your structure. So we have just one beam here. This beam is by default selected for design, and I can just click here on this I to start the calculation. The program is calculating the rest of the load combinations and then doing the concrete design, and then you get a result that looks basically like this. You get an overview of all possible problems in your structure or design errors. That is one overview, or you could also switch to design ratios on members, and then you see basically all the design checks, let's say for one member. And there you see what is fulfilled and what is not fulfilled. So I have just applied the basic reinforcement layout, and for these loadings, for example, this section resistance verification is not fulfilled, or the crack control is not fulfilled, and so on. And therefore, I can now optimize the reinforcement. So I will open the member once again, and now we can go through all these tabs here and check what we can optimize here. So the first new chapter would be here the concrete effective length. That is basically if you want to do the stability analysis. I will show it to you in this in the second example. In this example, it's not necessary here. The next step would be regarding the concrete covering, and there by default it is XC1 here for the Eurocode. You could also create a new one here by using this new picture here, which shows you possible exposure clauses. And yeah, let's say we use here, for example, XC3 as a second exposure clause. And if you switch from these two exposure clauses, then you see also how these directly have an influence on the concrete covering. And as a further option, you could also say that you want to use a different exposure clause, let's say on the top side and on the bottom and left and right side, so it looks like this. Next would be the shear reinforcement. That is, as already said, preset here. So we have a rebar diameter of 10 millimeters and a distance of the individual shear links of 30 centimeters. And that is over the total length of 8 meters here applied. And I can now optimize it a little bit. So I could say I will leave it here for with a diameter of 10 millimeters, but I would like to start, let's say, with 10 centimeter distance of the individual links. That would look like this here. But I could also apply here individual spans with different spacing. So therefore, I can just click here and add here new spans. And you see already how this program divides this member now in two spans. And I would use here four spans. So the first span is going here as relative. I change it to absolute dimension from 0 to, let's say, 1.5 meters. Then the next one should be also with the same diameter, but in my example, let's say 0.2 meters. And it should go from 1 meter up to 5 meters. Then the next one is from 5 to 7 meters, that's okay. And then using again 10 centimeters, and in this rest here, this last meter, I want to use again 20 centimeters as a distance. So we have now here different spans, four different spans with different spacing of the individual shear links applied. That's one option here. And as said before, we had a problem with this predefined or with this preset for the longitudinal reinforcement that the cross-section was not fulfilled, or the design checks was not fulfilled for this reinforcement. So there we can also do an optimization here. So we could switch here for the unsymmetrical reinforcement, for example, and edit it. So let's say I would like to apply four rebars here on the top side with a diameter of 14 millimeters. On the sides, I would like to have two rebars with 10 centimeters, and on the bottom side, four rebars with 20 millimeters. So that would be my new reinforcement layout, which I want to verify here. And I can click here on apply, and then this will be applied here in on our structure. And just to finish this options which we have here in this edit member dialog, I'm switching to the next tab here. There we have the possibility to edit this default configuration for the ultimate limit state and for the serviceability limit state. I can just open it short for you, and there you see what you can basically edit. You could switch on and off certain shear forces or torsional moments. If you don't want to design the member for a certain internal forces, then you can also decide how the program should handle the shear force reduction, moment redistribution, and so on. So that is basically all part of the ultimate configuration, and we have the same regarding minimum reinforcement for restraint and crack risk control in the serviceability configuration. The next dialog here would be regarding design support. So in RFM 6 we have now the opportunity to enter design supports for the beam, and these design supports are required for this moment redistribution and shear force reduction, and also for determination of the reference length for the deflection control. So therefore, for this example, I would like to create a design support with you. So I'm creating a new one on the start here. I can switch to the concrete and confirm this. So you see here this red dot here, or this red box, that is our design support here on the left side. And we have here this cantilever, so this part will be free, but on this part where we have our support in the model, we can also create a design support. Concrete, and this one I will choose an inner support, and it looks now like this. And with these two design supports, I can tell the program that it should consider these design supports to determine the reference lengths for the deflection analysis. That's basically the reason why we have to enter these design supports, and of course also for the moment redistribution and shear force reduction. Okay, then I can confirm this, and with the settings I can just click here on this button once again, and the program starts to calculate the internal forces once again and do the analysis or concrete design add-on once again, and then we get here a further info which verification was not fulfilled, and in this part this was the is the deflection calculation. So here I have missed something for deflection calculation. Anyway, I will cover that later in the testing before that went out. I think I've messed up something on the input data. However, that is basically the process. So you have to enter a reinforcement, and the program afterwards will show you the design checks for the individual calculation. So for example, here we have now our section resistance verification with around about 90%, and then you see here this results, the same we have here for the shear force and so on. And if you want to see the amount of required reinforcement, then you can check off here this design checks, switch to reinforcement, and then you see here, I just close it a little bit, the required reinforcement, the provided reinforcement, and the not covered reinforcement. So here you can check before modifying the provided reinforcement. You can of course check here also the amount of required reinforcement on the bottom side and at the top side. Here it is. And I can just increase it a little bit for you to see it. So you see here the amount of required reinforcement, and then you can of course also show the amount of the provided reinforcement due to this reinforcement which we have defined here. So that would look like this here. We have this also for the stirrups, and here you could activate this not covered reinforcement option just to check whether there are parts of the structure of the beam in which you have not covered the required reinforcement. So then you have to, or then you could with this info modify your reinforcement proposal once again. Okay, that was basically just a short overview on a simple structure about the general approach in RFM 6. And now I would like to switch over to a more realistic model where we have also surfaces and other beams and ribs. Therefore, I'm switching to this example here. And in this example, we have surfaces and also ribs, which we can analyze. And we have, here these points where we can also do the punching design checks. At first, I would like to start with the surfaces. I will do this here for this surface. So I'm selecting this one, and then you can basically, like in RFM 5, create a visibility mode for this slab here. And for this slab, you can now do the analysis by entering at first some reinforcement. So I will go here once again into the types for concrete design, and there you see concrete durability. That is basically like before in this model with the beam. And what's new now is here the second tab here, this reinforcement direction. So our surface has already a reinforcement direction attached, and that means we have now here the first reinforcement direction goes into local x direction of the surface. Basically you can decide here in which direction which local axis direction the reinforcement should show. That can be controlled here with this option, and on the next tab, that here reinforcement, that would basically be this part of the navigator, you could assign a surface reinforcement to the surface. So in this example, I would like to use a mesh of rebars with a diameter of 10 millimeters and a spacing of 15 centimeters into this direction number one. So this is basically direction number one here in our local x direction. And I will also consider an additional reinforcement in this transverse direction, though that would basically be here this direction 2 on the top and on the bottom side. Confirm that with OK, and now you see here this reinforcement for the surface. Click on OK, and now you see this surface, this reinforcement here assigned to the surface. And what we can now do is go to the concrete design add-on and select, for example, this surface here for design. And if you now click on the show results button, then the program is already performing the analysis for this surface. So it's pretty straightforward. You have to assign a certain amount of reinforcement, and then you just do the calculation for the individual parts, and you get design criterions for the concrete design, whether they are fulfilled or not. And if they are not fulfilled, then we can check the results here, for example, like this. Let's not check this one because it always looks strange, because it are the results on the mesh nodes. So we can also go here to this table, and that looks not so critical, but we can use, for example, here not the graphics here with design checks, but we can now use the graphic with the not covered reinforcement. So I have defined here a provided reinforcement of 5.24 square centimeters per meters in both direction and on both sides of the surface, and now I can just control here or check here whether I have certain parts of the structure where this amount of provided reinforcement is exceeded. So here in this part, you see it here by this color, we have here some parts of the structure where our base reinforcement is not enough, and we have to take care about these areas here. So we have this on the top side in both direction, and on the bottom side, it's just here one small point that maybe can be neglected. So now it's the question how we can deal with such situations where we have parts of the structure where our reinforcement is not covering all required reinforcement, and therefore we can assign here additional reinforcement. And that's also pretty simple, because we can just do a right click on the surface reinforcement, create a new surface reinforcement, also here on this surface number 11, and this time I will not choose here this location type on surface. This time I will switch to free rectangular, and now I will just apply it on the top side, because we have checked before the result not covered reinforcement, and there we have seen that we have just parts of the structure on the top side which are not covered completely. So I will just assign it here on the top side. Once again, also with the same amount of rebars, with diameter of 10 millimeter and a spacing of 15 centimeters, also in both directions. And as an option, we could now enter here a offset to the previously defined base reinforcement, but I will arrange this reinforcement in the same layer. So next to the existing rebars, I would like to assign this additional reinforcement, and now I just have to take care where exactly this additional reinforcement should be assigned on the surface. Therefore, I'm switching to the next table, and there I have here these two options basically. Once is by defining the corner points, and the other option would be by definition of the center points and the dimension in A and B dimension or A and B direction. So the center would be here in this example here over the column here, for example, and I would like to use it with 2 by 2 meters. Confirm with OK. And then it would look like this. So we see now here on this surface our base reinforcement. I can switch this also off here via the display navigator. There you find the types for the concrete design. And here we can deactivate the reinforcement on the surface, and then we see just our additional reinforcement. And this additional reinforcement can be modified like usual member and surface elements in RFM. So we can select it, click here on this button, move and copy selected objects, create a copy of this additional reinforcement, and copy it from this column to this column, for example. And then we have assigned our additional reinforcement. And now the program, start the calculation once again. And now the program would consider not just the base reinforcement, but also the additional reinforcement in these areas where we have two layers. But before starting the calculation here, I would like to take care about the ribs in this example. So I'm switching off this visibility mode once again. And I will talk a little bit about the ribs in this file, because in this file we have here two slabs or levels with ribs. There are basically differences in the upper and in the bottom part. In the upper part, I'm just opening this one here. There I can show you the definition type for the ribs here. This is basically new compared to RFM 5. In RFM 5, it was not possible to assign a different effective width for a member. So you had always a constant integration width over the total length of the member. In RFM 6, we have optimized this, and now it's possible. I just rotated a little bit. Let you see it better. Now you can work with individual or different integration width and effective width for certain parts of the member. So for this part, for example, the total length of this member is 5 meters, and in the first 4.25 meters, I have a segment where we using here, for example, this width here, effective width, and here on these parts here, on this right part, we are here over the column. There we can now use here the Eurocode equation with a reduced width, and I have separated it in this example because there are two options here. Here we have it without a linear distribution. So here it looks like this. And in the lower slab, I have basically the same, but here, if I rotate it once again, there I have activated here a linear distribution for these ribs. So I can also say that I want here to have a linear distribution between the individual segments of this rib. And that is basically done for this member here. For this one in the middle, it looks like this. And now the program is able to do the calculation and do the design checks for every X location of the member with the correct integration width and effective width for the rib. So that's also a new feature compared to RFM 5, and that means also we can also calculate with different integration width also for the set of members. If you would create a set of member for the whole rib, then it would be also possible to calculate with different integration widths. If I'm going once again into this edit member dialog and switching now to the shear reinforcement, then I can create here a reinforcement, and I will now create here once again such spans here for this for this RIP. So I would like to use here a diameter of 8 millimeter and a spacing of 0.15 millimeters at the beginning. And it should go up to 1.5 meter here. So that is my first span. The second span is here with 8 millimeters and a distance of 30 centimeters from 1.5 meter up to 3.5 meters. And in the last part, I would like once again this one. Okay, that is my shear reinforcement. I want to consider in this calculation, and the only thing that's missing here is the longitudinal reinforcement. Therefore, I'm creating a new longitudinal reinforcement here, and this time I would like to use the unsymmetrical ones again on the top side, let's say 3 rebars with a diameter of 12 millimeters, on the bottom side the same. And what's missing now here is the reinforcement in these flanges. And there we have also a new option in RFM 6. So at first I would like to apply this reinforcement. And if you see now the reinforcement, how it looks like currently, then I just rotate the structure and then you see how the member will be reinforced here. And one new option is that we can now consider the reinforcement of the slabs in the flanges of the beam. So therefore I can click on this button here, and then the program takes the amount of rebars, longitudinal reinforcement, that is basically already set in the surfaces as a reinforcement in these flanges here. And it looks like this in the graphic. And we could just switch to another X location, and then you see here also the infographic here. And in the part where we have this wider width, then you see here the cross-section, how it looks like. So in the center, we have here our shear links with the 3 rebars on the top and on the bottom side. And here in the flanges, the program applies the longitudinal reinforcement from the surface. So that is basically now the, or these are the new options for the RIPs in RFM 6. So I will confirm that with OK, and I will leave this, and I will just add this member here to design. That was the member 22. And we have still two topics that are not covered here in this case. One is the punching, and the last one is the stability analysis. At first I will just talk about the punching in RFM 6. So of course we have also the option to do the punching analysis in RFM 6. Therefore you can select a certain node which you would like to analyze for punching. I would like to do it for the first 4 columns here. I select the nodes, do a double click on it, and then if the concrete design add-on was activated, then you can also activate here on these columns, for example on these nodes, the punching. Confirm that with OK. And here we can also select nodes where we would like to do the punching. This one. Okay. And now with this setting, the program takes the reinforcement from the surface, the basic reinforcement, and applies this longitudinal reinforcement for the punching verification. So in this node here and in this node, our base reinforcement. And in these two columns here, or these two points, it uses the sum of the base reinforcement here in this slab and also the additional reinforcement that is basically assigned to this node here. Before starting the final calculation, I will just take care about the stability analysis of the columns here. And in the current state of RFM 6, we have implemented the analytical solution for the stability analysis, and therefore we have to apply here effective lengths to the individual columns. Before I'm applying the individual effective lengths, I would like to go back once again into the space data dialog. And in the space data dialog, I would like to show you one new feature here that is that can be found here in this options tab here. And there you find these member representatives. And if you activate them, then you get this tab here, and the program is now creating member representatives depending on this property, so from material up to the length, and also depending on comments and on concrete design properties. What that basically means will be better visible if I confirm that with OK. Because now you see this colored bubbles here, and if I'm opening here this member representatives, then you can see what I'm meaning, because the program has now collected all parts of the structure which have basically the same properties into this member representatives. That means, for example, in this member representative with this red bubble here, that are our column in the first columns in the first floor, and with the green dot here, that are our columns here in the second floor. And if I open it, then I could directly edit these member representatives and add there some design properties. So for example, here in this case, I would like to do the stability analysis just for the columns in the first floor. So I open it once again, and there you find here once again the concrete covering and the shear force and the longitudinal reinforcement. So I will just go quickly through these dialogues. I would like to enter here a diameter of 8 millimeter with a distance of 15 centimeters for the columns, and the longitudinal reinforcement should look like this. I would like to use here a uniform surrounding reinforcement from 8 rebars with a diameter of 12 millimeter, and I assign it, and then you see here that by using these member representatives, you can very fast assign reinforcement to your structure. So basically, all columns of this one member representative have now the same reinforcement. If I click here on this member representative and create here a new visibility, then you have also option to select this one here and, for example, assign here certain parts like the effective lengths. So I'm creating a new effective length. In this part, I would like to use here the braced one with a buckling length or a factor of 1.0 in both directions. And I can just click on this button, and with this window, I can assign this effective length to all these columns in the first floor. Confirm that with OK. And then you see here these buckling length factors, and you can also go to the types for concrete design and deactivate it, for example. that's too much info for you, then you can also control it via the display properties or the display navigator. I have to consider them also in the design checks, and then after that steps I will start the calculation, and with the results, if I've got the results, then we can check once again the design checks. Just waiting a second for the results, because the program is now performing the whole structure or all parts of the structure which are assigned to this concrete design add-on at once. So you will now get results for, let's close it here, for all parts. So you get results, design checks for the members, the surfaces and the nodes in result navigator. The same is here for the reinforcement. You get the reinforcement for the members, the surfaces and the nodes for the punching design checks. And if we now go to the design ratios on the members, for example, then we see here our columns, and let's just switch on the design checks for the members. Okay, we have here the design check for the section resistance. Let's select maybe this column here, and if I click on this button, then I can just show the results for this column here. And we have here a design criterion of almost 80%. If I open it, then you see here also a new feature in RFM 6, because you now can control the whole calculation of all design checks here via this design check details. So basically it's not a black box what we are calculating, because you get now all informations about all design checks that are available. Also here with this equations of the Eurocode, and you can now easily verify these results here. And one last topic I forgot to mention is regarding the interaction diagram. That's also a new feature in RFM 6. So you can now activate this interaction diagram. And if this one was activated, then you get here this tab, and there we have a new interaction diagram here in RFM 6. So the time is running out a little bit for me, but I would just like to mention some points regarding the printout report. Therefore, I would just cancel this visibility mode here. I would deactivate the types for concrete design, and I will just, for example, show the results here for the slab, for example. Then I go back to the result navigator and show, for example, the required reinforcement for the slab. In Z direction. And basically what you can now print to the to the printout report is basically the same like in RFM 5 before. So you can now generate these graphics here and print them to this printout report. Therefore, I will just give you a short example. I will create a new printout report, not with all this data here. I will switch it off. So I will create a new one, an empty one. And then I can, for example, use here this option, print graphics to the printout report. And I would like to use here in this example this multi-print for the full page height and go here to the add-on. And then we have once again here design checks and reinforcement and the reinforcement on the surfaces. I would like, for example, print the required reinforcement on the top and bottom side in all directions here. So we have four graphics here. That would look like this. Here, let's print it in this way, just to give you an overview about the printout report, how it looks like. So we have now here this printout report, and we can now, as already known from RFM 5, create here our printout reports. I will just add here a result maybe for the beams. Let's say use this beam. This way. And then we used just the current view, looks like this. And I will not print it over the full page height, but maybe miss 50%. Save and show. And then you get here this page for, or this picture for this result. And what we can now also do here in this printout report is create folders. So I could say, for example, for surfaces, one chapter and a new one for the beams. But that is then up to you. There you are pretty free how you organize your printout reports. So you can take this one and put them into this chapter, and here if you have more graphics for the members or beams, then you could put them here. And that could be also be done for the for the punching. I will just, because the time is running out a little bit, show the desired check, the results for the punching. That would look like this. Yeah. And I just print this graphic here. Maybe with the full height. And rotate it by 90 degrees, maybe just for an example. Oh, let's use this one, looks maybe a bit better. Okay, save and show. And then you have here the design checks for the punching. So that is basically an overview of, quick overview of the current state of RFM 5, RFM 6 and the concrete design add-ons. So currently we have the ultimate limit state and serviceability limit state for the beams and surfaces and the punching and other calculations like nonlinear calculations and so on. Will be released in further time, I would say. Okay, thanks for your attention, and with this I would like to hand over the screen back to Andreas.
Okay, thank you, Paul, for this nice presentation, also with the documentation in the printout report. Just an information for all attendees. We recorded the webinar, and I hope in the next week you will get an email with a link to the video and to the models that you can download and then you can follow the video step by step with the provided models. I would like to show you where you can find all. Just a moment, I take over the screen. So you will get an email with a link to that here, news and events webinars. You find the webinar here, but the link that is in the email, link directly to this that page here, and you will find the video here and also here, and the model, you can see the model is already here. It's from the German webinar. Yesterday was the same webinar in German, and here are the two models. But yeah, just wait for the recording of the webinar. So I would like to thank you for your attendance and attention, and thank you to my colleagues for answering the questions, and thanks to Paul for the nice presentation. Have a nice day, stay healthy, and bye-bye.